See, this question is very interesting question. In a figure, arm PQ of a rectangular conductor moved from x is equal to 0 towards right hand side with constant velocity v. Length of the arm is say L, and we are extending this motion of the conductor from PQ to P dash Q dash, which is x is equal to 2b. Now question is, sketch variation of magnetic flux, EMF, force, power with respect to the distance. So just see how can you sketch it. See, when this is moved from A, x is equal to 0 to B, the magnetic flux link with it continuously changes, right? And then from this to this, this will be a constant because it is out of the magnetic field. So from x is equal to b to x is equal to 2b will be constant. When it is moving towards this, then from point B again, it is moving to in the magnetic field, it starts decreasing. So let's see, one scale is this. This is about magnetic flux, phi v with respect to distance. What will be the shape of the graph? First it increases, then it becomes constant, continues constant, and then it decreases to zero. This is x is equal to 0 to b, in between somewhere it will be 2b, and this is b again, so it starts decreasing. This comes back to the zero again. On the basis of this, you on the same scale you can plot graph, other graphs. Then force, EMF, first you can easily see EMF with respect to this. Now EMF induces always in opposite direction to the rate of change of flux. So up to B, EMF induced will be in opposite direction, and the value will be minus BLV. Then it in between B to this B back, it remains zero here, and then again it jumps up in positive direction, and this value will be BLV positive. Same graph will be for force, because force is also varying according to the same factor, right? Force can also be positive and negative. And third graph is power. Power is never negative. So in case of power, you will have both positive sides. This positive, then zero, then again you will find positive power coming up here. This value will be equal to V square L square V square over R. Two more questions we can see here. Number one is coil. Question number two is, a coil having area 2 meter square is placed in uniform magnetic field which changes from this to this. Okay. So answer is, flux is equal to B into S d phi v over dt. I can talk about only magnitude. Then what is changing? Magnetic field. So this will be dB dt into S, because area is constant. You can find dB over dt easily. That is 4 minus 1 over time interval is 2 into S is 2. That comes out 3 by 2 minus 1 into, that is 3 volt. Another question is, this a conducting rod of length L. Let's see the solution of this question. This is a magnetic field. A conducting rod of length L is rotated in the field about its one of its end. About its one of the end. So this is O, length is L. This you can say it is rotated. We assume that it is moved from position A to B by distance x, angle traverse is d theta. So it sweeps area. Change in area. First you find it out area. I think that will be better for you to understand. Area covered. Area swept by the rod. So dA is equal to what? Half x into L. I can make this triangle separately here. This is small angle d theta. Length is, this is x. So you can consider x as almost perpendicular. So half length raised one side into perpendicular. Right now, but d theta by definition is x over L, so this d theta, yes, so x is equal to L d theta, therefore dA is equal to half L square d theta. Therefore, induced EMF E is equal to d phi b over dt. So it is b into dA over dt. So I have done two questions. In one question, magnetic field is changing with time. In another question, area is changing with time. So you can put it as E is equal to half L square d theta over dt, and d theta over dt is, and b also is there, and d theta over dt is what? Omega. So half L square b omega. So what is answer? Half b L square omega. Two more simple questions. One is asked in CBSE 2017. Horizontal conducting rod of 10 meter long. So L is 10 meter. Strength of horizontal magnetic field into 10 raised to the power minus 4. And speed is 5 meter per second. So state all data are available. Induced EMF is VLV. It is a straight conducting rod, 0.3 10 raised to power minus 4 into 10 into 5. Right? So you can write it as 1.5 into 10 raised to the power minus 3 volt or 1.5 millivolt. Next question is question number 5. Magnetic flux question says is 3TQ. It's a function based question. So obviously you have to use differentiation. For finding induced EMF, magnitude of induced EMF, d phi v over dt. So differentiate this, 90 square minus 4t plus 4, 2 is 0. And at what time? T is equal to 2 seconds. So put it here. 9 into 2 is square minus 4 into 2 plus 4. Answer 36 minus 8 plus 4. Right? This is minus 4, 28. Induced EMF, it is volt.